What up, Facebook and YouTube? Here, I have like four things on my agenda, and so I haven't made any videos recently. Here's hopefully going to be all four things in one single video. I see now that the zipper on my jacket is dangling, and well, what can you do sometimes? So I'm just sitting here near the fireplace, warming up. And I think the clouds just completely adjusted the lighting in the room. Anyways, so some of my recent videos have been about matrices and matrix, multiple matrices. And it's a mathematical term, sort of just like a grid of numbers and stuff like that. It's sort of hard to understand. I watched Total Recall with my dad last night. I think that movie should be called No Recollection. But the original, I watched the original from... I think it was the year 1990. Anyways, it has a lot to do with the themes of the movie The Matrix from 1999. So anyways, here's a Wikipedia, would probably be generally the best place to start. So the first thing on the agenda was to make like a chart, but I have to have some kind of something going in the background just for like audio purposes. Why not, you know? So, recently, Dana Carvey, whose character is from Wayne's World, it rhymes with the best-selling country singer, Garth. Oh, it doesn't rhyme. It's the exact same name as Garth Brooks. Garth from Wayne's World. Anyways, so here's how to find podcasts of... the best way that I think to listen to them is on Google Podcasts. Here's one called Cute Little Alien. And I think he just recently started up a podcast with some of his personal friends. Anyway, so it's here's just an example. And then so I press the play button. And then I think it loads at the bottom here. It says, you know, it's a 1 hour podcast. And here I can change the speed of it, and I generally listen to podcasts at 2x speed. For some reason, the audio's not working. That's okay, because what I had planned for the soundtrack, anyways, was a 1960s playlist that I spent at least 1 hour putting together just the top 100 songs from the... And I made this channel here just for... because my playlists were getting disorganized on my main YouTube channel, so I created this one called... 3 billion views and 1.1 trillion subscribers. This video is just called 1960s songs, and it's those that I had recognized. I think nearly everyone should recognize every single one of these songs. Some of them maybe not. Some of them I know from country music, like and from different movies and stuff, like Roses Are Red. Is a song played at the Copacabana in the movie Goodfellas. I'm almost certain. Hello Mary Lou is a well-known country song. And of course, at the very top is the Shirelles' Mama Said. And in my opinion, that song's about a rainy day. It's like, it's about like, you know, we just had a blizzard and everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with that song again. There were still some more things on the agenda. And that was in my memo. So I was going to try to analyze just the first letter of my surname, Petrino. And instead of that, I'm going to go for Vespucci's surname, because it's going to be easier without curves. Like a V doesn't have a curve. So it's really just two math equations and two different charts or whatever it's called. Okay, so that's everything. And the reason that I got derailed was because I was going to try to make a chart of my own. Before I show that, this is going to be just like a math book cover for the math instruction. Like, I also have the Rad College of Music on my YouTube channel, and that's just using websites to play instruments. You don't even have to buy an actual guitar, bass, or amplifier, which could run about $1,000. Instead, just using, at the very least, for tuning purposes of a real instrument, just this website. So I'm going to call this book Math Ace. So I'm going to write the word math over here and then ace. So math ace. For two different times, I tried to go through and make a chart here, just an XY coordinates chart. And I spent at least 30 minutes meticulously putting every little thing in the, to make a just a regular graph. And like a graph canvas. And I accidentally pressed the, the cancel button and lost all my work twice. And that button's up here. I actually touched it with my palm, like when I was making the finishing touches. And so what this chart's gonna look like, it's gonna be like this. First I'll go with the x-axis. And here's just a quick example. And also like right there. That's the y-axis. So it's a really cool looking chart, in my opinion. So that's going to be the x-axis over here.
Are you ready?
I always forget how to draw an x. That's supposed to be an x. And there's also
one, two, three,
yeah, it's just the x-axis over here. And then number one, two, three, four, and then five is going to be bigger.
Hello, Mary Lou.
One, two, three, four,
goodbye,
five, like that.
Sweet Mary Lou,
so it sort of looks like laces on a football. Also,
Mary
looks like stitches. Like, this is from the movie Scarface.
So, hello, Mary Lou,
like that. Hey. Anyways, it's a really cool looking chart, in my opinion. And then it's just called Math Ace. And I think this is the album of the songs of the movie. It's really here and over there. It's sort of hard to explain.
I said, hello, Mary Lou.
So that's supposed to be called Math Ace, and that's just supposed to be like a chart. Okay, so I don't know if I was going to continue with that and use this, because the last one I had looked like a blueprint. I suppose I could redo a, like a blueprint. But instead of that, I was going to use things over here and Chrome.
Heard your voice, believe me, I just
like
the,
Dana Carvey podcast is called A Cute Little Alien. This Android icon or whatever it's called an icon or something, or a robot. It's supposed to look like a motherboard. One of these pictures looks like a motherboard. And so I thought it would be, and it's also the colors of the Matrix. I don't know if, maybe this is just an introduction, because I don't have a, like a graph. I guess I'll go ahead and use the one that I just was using. So I'm just going to go ahead and, crop out one part to use as the chart or whatever. I'll press done. And this song is from a movie. It's from The Parent Trap. Okay, so what I was going to do, here's quadrant one up here, quadrant two, quadrant three, and quadrant four. I'll go ahead and label those. One, two, three, and four. So I'm just gonna start with the letter V for Vespucci. And so that's, let's just say three. This point right here is three and one. So it has a, because there's one, two, three, and then one step up. That's going to be a total of four steps, but in different directions. So the way to write that is going to be three for the x value, and that's a comma, and one. It's for the first plot, and then for the second and the third plot is going to be here, right here. Sort of like the Roman numeral 5. And when I say sort of, I mean exactly. So that's going to be 2 and 2 on the left side. 2 and 2. And it's also going to be 3 and 2. So these are three different points over here on the letter V.
A long, long time.
The question remains, how can these three equations be put into one single equation, taking the average? And so another word for average is mean. Like, even like the Saturday Night Live movie, Mean Girls, what it means is like average girls. And I think in that movie it has a theme of like a math club type thing. So the first plot on the letter V, let me point to it. So I'll draw another letter V. First plot is right here. The second and third plots are going to be right here. And then, you know, all the way up here. So that's 1, 2, and 3. I'll label 1, 2, and 3. Okay. And let's see. So what I'm trying to do is, or I'm going to write the equations for them. The first one's going to be, if the plot is these coordinates right here, 3 and 1, right here, the equation for that is going to be x, or it's going to be y equals, and y is the value of the vertical line right here, and x is the value of the horizontal line. Okay, so it's going to be y equals, so if y equals, I'm going to have to draw a line connecting this one right here. Okay, and that one. So y equals 1. So it's also could be written as 1 equals, and these are different equations, so I'm going to draw a line. 1 equals x and 3. So I'll put x here for 3, and x is called a variable. And so actually it might be x plus 3 instead of x times 3. Anyways, this is just simple arithmetic and algebra for the first plot, and then on the second plot it's going to be a similar thing. But I'm trying to simplify it even more, so I didn't even solve for x there, or rather solve for y, but I think most of that was right, but I can always go back and do that later. So these are three different equations, because there's three different points on the graph. Y equals... I'm getting confused now. So I'm looking at this 3 and 1 right here. The monster mash. Y equals... so if x is 3 and y is 1... Well, y equals mx plus b is going to be how these charts work. And that's algebra, I think. Running out of space already. I think I have my pen way too large. That's what's going on. Okay. So I'm going to take those coordinates and plug them into this equation. Y equals 3. Actually, y equals 1. M is the value of the slope of the line. The x value is going to be, we put parentheses, 3, and then plus b. Is this right? I don't know if this is right. If there's two variables, I can't solve for either one, so I'm going to have to figure this out later. This is definitely just an introduction and part one. If a V was only half of what it is, if it was just this, it's really easy to solve on a chart. Say that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Each point is going to be 1 and 1, 2 and 2, 3 and 3, 4 and 4. So Y is going to equal X. And that's as simple as it gets. I'll have to gather my thoughts and restart these videos, or this video series.